Let them die in childbirth. That's why they are here.
So shall we see Christianity?
So shall we see what your prophet? Shall we see what your prophet? Does anyone want to hear what your prophet said about women?
Why are you always wearing the same clothes?
But what I'm saying, if you're out here preaching, misrepresenting the faith, then you should be able to be challenged for what you're talking about.
Contradicted to the Bible, but the Quran is more superior than that. The Quran not just give rights to the man, but also give rights to the woman as well. For example, the Almighty God Allah said in the Quran in Surah Al-Araf, chapter 7, ayah 19, ayah 23, in the meaning, inshallah. Allah said in the meaning, He said, Ya Adam, O Adam, dwell with your wife in the garden of Jannah and enjoy as you wish, but approach not this tree or run into the harm and the transgression and the shaitan who makes waswas to... Brother, can you move this? Hello. Can you move this to me, please? The smoke is haram. Thank you.
Let him speak.
Don't disrespect this. Go over there. Don't smoke, please. Hello.
Brother, you behind me. He's spreading Islam.
No. Don't smoke behind me, please. Don't respect me. Why you smoke behind me? Can you go over there? No.
Are you Muslim? Are you Muslim?
Are you Muslim? Yeah,
why are you stopping his speech?
You are Muslim, don't have respect, but have Islam, man. I don't like these things, man. I don't like these things, man.
You don't represent Islam.
I'm not doing a talk, man. You're disrespecting, man. Have Islam for yourself. Have Hishma for yourself.
Itaqillah.
Can you come over here?
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry to me. You're sorry to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the day of judgment. La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah.
People don't help him.
So, sorry, back to the Quran. A'udhu billahi min shaitani wajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. The meaning from the Quran, Surah Al-Araf, chapter 7, ayah 90 to 23. O Adam, dwell with your wife in the garden and enjoy as you wish. And approach not this tree and you run into the haram and the transgression. So here in the Quran, we have this account. The Quran is very superior to the Bible. The Quran says from Surah Al-Araf chapter 7 ayah 93 that Allah was speaking to Adam alayhi salam and to his wife in the Jannah, the paradise, not to go to the forbidden tree. But when they went there, the shaitan made the waswas or caused doubt to them and advised them to take it, and as they did this, they asked Allah for forgiveness, and Allah forgave them so that they will not be lost. The Bible said the opposite. The Bible said that God called them from the garden in Genesis 2 verse 4 and Genesis 3:24. He called them and said, why art thou hiding? So are you telling me that God didn't know where they were? Well, you don't feel me. No. Don't feel me. I don't want you to feel me. No.
You go to Hatun.
No. Go feel me. I don't want you to feel me. No. I don't want nobody to feel me. No.
He's ashamed. That's why. Because.
No.
He's ashamed. Continue what your scripture says.
I'm not telling you what to do.
Continue.
I bet Allah is listening. No.
But you're telling him what to do.
I'm not talking over here. I'm moving over here. I don't want you to feel me.
You can't stop his movement.
Don't film me.
Right, obviously, twisting his head.
Try again. So, ask if Kevin looks. What the Quran says. The Quran is Alhamdulillah. If then a Kevin look into the two accounts of the story of the creation, reveals some of the difference. The Quran, and contrary to the Bible, places that equal to the blame both of Adam and Eve or Hawa for their mistakes. Nowhere in the Quran can one find even a slightest hint, even tempted that Adam to eat from the tree, or even that she had eaten before him. So even in the Quran, it is no temptress or seducer or no deceiver. Moreover, Eve or Hawa is not to be blamed for the place of child bringing. God, according to the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, punishes no one for another's fault.
Okay, where was the Quran when Torah was revealed? Where was the Quran when Torah was revealed?
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness.
Where was the Quran when Torah was revealed?
Forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from them both. Go find your own platform.
Continue. So if you're misrepresenting my faith.
So the Bible says, what does the Bible say? In one part of the New Testament, and I'm going to read the statement from the church fathers, it says, I do not permit that a woman should learn in silence and through submission. I do not permit a woman to teach or to have authority over a man. She must be in silence. For Adam was foremost the first, and Eve, and Adam was not one deceived. Was the woman was deceived and become a sinner. 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 11 to 14. So what did the Bible just say? The Bible says the woman was deceived. And the woman shall learn in silence. And it's shameful for a woman to speak openly about this. Is in the Bible, it's not Quran. But what we find out from the church fathers, listen to this, my brothers, Muslimin, I think the Muslims, alhamdulillah. It says the church fathers, Christian fathers, church fathers said this. Listen to what they say. It says, I'll read a few of them. It says, one of them was Saint Augustine. Was faithful in the legacy of his predecessors. He wrote to his friend, he said, what is the difference whether it is in a wife or a mother? It is still Eve, the temptress, but we must beware of it. Any woman, I fail to see what use woman can be to a man if one excludes the function of bearing children. That's one. Another one, church father is St. Thomas Aquilus. He stated that consider woman as deficient. Christianity church fathers say he considered Saint Thomas Aquilus said that consider woman deficient. He said as regards as the individual nature, woman is deficient and is misbegotten. For the active force in the male seed tends unto the production of perfect likeness in the masculine sex, while the production of woman comes from a defect in the active force, or from some material imposition, or even from some eternal influence. And finally, Martin Luther, the one who brought the Reformation, he himself said he could not see any benefit from a woman but bringing into the world as many children as possible, regarding or any side effects. If they become tired or they even die, that does not matter. Let them die in childbirth. That's why they are here.
So shall we see what your prophet? Does anyone want to hear what your prophet said about women? No, because look how he's misrepresenting Christianity. Explain to me this. In Sahih Bukhari, it says once Allah's messenger went out to Masala to offer prayers and Idullah and Fitr prayers. Then passed by a woman and said, O woman, give alms. I've seen that the majority of dwellers of Hellfire were you. They asked, why is this so? Allah's messenger said, you curse frequently and are ungrateful to your husband. I have not seen anyone more deficient in intelligence and religion than you. A cautious, sensible man could be led astray by some of you. The woman asked, O Allah's messenger, what is the deficiency in our intelligence and our religion? He said, it is not the evidence of two women equal to the witness of one man. They then replied in affirmative. He said, this is the deficiency
deficiency of her intelligence, isn't it true that a woman can neither pray or fast during her menses? So your own prophet has said women are deficient in two things. You want to read? This is Sahih Bukhari. Authentic.
For the Muslim man,
this is the words of your own prophet.
For the believing man,
he said the women are more deficient in intelligence.
For true men and women,
deficient in their religion. So he's
the internet. For men and women
who are this is Sahih Bukhari. This is your own website. Look,
Sunnah.com.
This is Sunnah. Okay. Look,
bring the Quran to me.
This is from a hadith.
Show me the English translation.
Look,
Chapter 9, Ayah 71. But believers,
But what I'm saying,
if you're out here preaching, misrepresenting the faith, then you should be able to be challenged of what you're talking about.
So we should do the same with him. The difference between you and him, he has the book.
Yeah.
You don't have the book.
I've got.
So that's not the book.
This is from Bukhari. I don't need the physical Bukhari. What is this book he's using? How do you know what he's saying is the truth?
Subtle go on.
You can check this out.
What can we check?
This is from Bukhari. This is a website called Sunnah. No. But listen, you're making a claim. What book is he reading from?
My point was he's reading from the book right now. You came in the circle just not to interject. While there was a whole crowd. You came to interject. That shows you that your religion is dying and you feel you have to interject on Muslim debates.
Okay. If he's talking about treatment of Christian women and misreading
the book right now.
Yes. But he's misrepresenting. If you're reading it, he's misrepresenting. I'm saying, how can you make a claim against my religion when your own religion says the same thing?
Is he talking about now? Is he saying that
I'm talking to him.
Talking about him.
He was listening. I'm talking to him.
He's got one thing though, if I may. There are five pillars of Sharia al-Islamiyya, Islamic law. Number one is the holy book, and number two is the hadith, the sunnah. He's reading from the sunnah.
Exactly.
What is it? What's it saying?
So, I'll read it to you again, because he said the early church fathers accused women of having deficiencies. So I'm saying, your prophet said the same thing.
Can you defend that, or are you going to try to go to the...
No, I'm saying, why... No, listen.
Hold on, guys. I have five minutes here. I haven't heard what he has to say.
Listen to what I'm saying.
Because so many people...
Listen.
You have to see it on that, and so many other people...
Listen.
I'm with you, but I want to hear it from him first. Yeah. We'll talk about it.
So...
I haven't heard it.
He was ranting with me on a topic, and I'm going to different hadith, and Quran, hadith, and different...
Okay. Now, the premise of this...
Look, the translation.
He said Christian women are, he said women according to Christianity are deficient. So I've said to him, why is it you will criticize Christianity when your prophet affirmed the same thing? But he's going from church fathers, not even the scripture. But I'm saying from the words of Muhammad himself, and I read this from Bukhari, because obviously this is not some anti-Islamic website, it's a Muslim website. They put the Sunnah online. So he says, this is what he said. He said, once Allah's messenger went out to the Musalla to offer prayer and fitra prayer, then he passed the woman and said, O woman, give alms, as I have seen that the majority of the dwellers of hellfire were you. And you can see it says women. They asked, why is it so, Allah's messenger?
Here's the thing. I hear what you're saying. Yes. But here's the thing. I know Arabic and I speak Arabic. Then
Arabic
I'm telling
right there.
You. Let me read this for a second,
okay.
If I may.
Read the Arabic.
It's about interpretation.
Yeah, it's the Arabic is right there.
Yeah, I'll read it. I'll tell you if that interpretation is correct in just a second.
Can you read it? Can you interpret in English while you're going along?
No, I can't read it. Okay, that's fine. But I'll tell you what. But the ila al musan. فمر على أن شيء فقار. يا يا مشرق النساء. تصدقن فإني أر أكثر أهل النار. It's right here. يا مخشر النساء. تصدقن فإن أريكن أكثر أهل النار. يا مخشر النساء. This is Mokshar. Mokshar is what I'm
used to. Yeah, read it all in and then give us a summary.
It's that quote. This could be interpreted. There's one word here that I don't know what it means.
Yeah, that's fine. Just read it all. And then you can say what you've gathered from this.
So why you see a woman
that
goes to church and saying Jesus? Alhamdulillah, you're up behind me. Even the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam,
he doesn't want to engage.
Because I don't mind. I want to see the objections
you are bringing. Can I simply ask the question? He's talking about my Bible. He's talking about my God. He deserves answer. He deserves answer.
Ignore her.
Today you can run away. On the day of judgment, you are not able to run away from Lord Jesus Christ. I've got questions. Are you Muslim?
Shameless.
Thank you. Are you Muslim?
Give your audience speech.
No, I am asking questions.
I have many questions.
So you are Muslim. Yes. Can you just simply tell me what does Quran teaches about women?
Let's say you are very really.
So you are new Muslim. You are learning. Why are you? How long have you been Muslim?
Just recently. Just
in Zachariah alone.
About that, yeah.
So you've been a Muslim for a week. What is the basic teaching? So I'm not asking you to give me your scholar interpretation. Asking very simple question. What does Islam teach about women? You don't even know that. Okay.
Islam is not subject to.
Since you are not able to answer my question, while you made a choice to become a Muslim, let me ask you a very, very general question. What is your top 10 reasons that you become a Muslim?
Muslim.
No,
I just wanted
reason.
To.
Reason? He wanted to know the truth about that.
So you become a Muslim to learn?
Not Muslim.
You can mock as much as you want. That's up to you. Still, my question still stands. He made a choice to become a Muslim. I asked him, what does Islam teach us about women? He doesn't know. I am asking him, why did you become a Muslim?
Islam teaches us God Almighty the way
he is.
So,
as you become a Muslim, can you just tell me what you are going to do?
I won't be able to answer.
What is your plan? Why didn't you become a Hindu? Why didn't
Then if you're Muslim, why are you wearing those jackets for? Why are you wearing those clothes for? Do you know they make them in sweatshirts? Old cousins.
Very good question. Why you always wear same clothes?
Well, you lot are good representation of Muslims, know that. Good representing your Muslim people. You represent good Muslims. You represent good Muslims. Good Muslims over there, no.
And you're good Christians.
They're good Muslims. No good Christians.
Look at them, hiding their faces.
No good Christians.
No
good Christians. They're being childish. Being grown up. Look, these are grown up guys. These are grown up. You're being a child. Grow up.
Be quiet.
Grow up.
Hey, listen a minute.
Grow up.
Be quiet.
Be quiet.
My problem with Islam is the teachings of the Quran.
Give me one teaching.
And
say in Arabic as well.
I tell you my dear.
So let the first bring up my concern
before you
of the woman that was I was trying to respond.
No,
men are in charge of women by what Allah has given one over the other and what they spend from their family. So righteous women are devoted to obedient, guarded in absence what Allah would have got them. But those wives from whom you fear arrogance, from whom you fear arrogance, advise them, forsake them in bed and strike them. But if they obey you, seek no means against them. Indeed, Allah is ever exalted and grand. So, my problem with this, not only for my concern for Muslims, my concern for humanity is...
Really?
No.
If you have concern for humanity, go and meet
them. You advise them, forsake them from the bed, and you strike them. If they obey you, not to God, if they obey your husband, everything is fine. So, since you are Arab, since you are Arabic speaker Muslim, can you just tell us Arabic version
of that? I'm not going to debate with you.
We want to see if the Arabic version simply tells us husband and wife in those conditions can have one chocolate. What is the Arabic version says?
Don't write bullshit cards.
Fair.
To help you.
No, but then you have no intention.
So you are telling me to go to the scholars?
Yes.
While Quran doesn't tell you, you must be Einstein to talk about Islam. I need to go to the scholars while your scholars, your Allah says Quran is well detailed, well explained, simple book. Yet you send me the scholars. That is just disgraceful to the Muslims. Week after week, you treat Quran as a quantum physics book and you send people to scholars. It is unacceptable. Quran is a book. Allah is able to communicate, should able to communicate in my language. I am concerned for the humanity because the teachings of the Quran. That's that simple it.